Yeah, so we released a statement this morning saying that we will not be formally attending the Women's March, and we didn't encourage our members to attend. There's been a lot of problems regarding the Women's March and accusations of anti-Semitism amongst some of its founding members. We have a zero tolerance policy for any form of bigotry or hate, and so we felt it was only right to remove any support that we were planning on giving to the Women's March. I think that the Women's March in 2016 was incredibly empowering. I left the march feeling empowered, inspired. Some of the speakers there were amazing women. And so that's why I think it's unfortunate what's happened to it now. Women as a whole, like, you can break them down into many different groups. And if you're, say, only advocating for wealthy white women or Christian women, you're leaving out entire masses of women. And the overall mission of the march is to empower all female voices, all voices in general, bring everyone to the table. There are many other ways to promote that mission statement that the Women's March has without promoting any hate or bigotry within its leadership.
The Women's March, when it was first organized, was a landmark moment. The movement and the march was remarkable in terms of really creating a new space for people to assert their rights, assert human rights, assert the rights of women, and be able to do that in a public, peaceful, and deeply political way. So how do you create a movement that speaks to all of these different experiences and that recognizes that there is no one singular category of women, and that depending on all these other markers of identity that we inhabit, right? Whether it's socioeconomic status, whether it's race, religion, nationality, linguistic background, sexual orientation, all of those other differences can shape the ways in which we might articulate political interest. When those moments of criticism and critique come up, we all have to sit down and think about this and talk it through.
I think that the march as an annual event encourages a sort of disconnect form of activism. So you show up for a day, you go on a fancy trip for the weekend up to DC, and you kind of stand, you know, and you sing songs and you have a good time and then you go home. There's not a lot of follow-up, there's not a lot of accountability for the people who are attending these marches.
I think that local engagement is incredibly crucial. I don't want to discourage anyone from going. Like I said, I think the principles of the march are an incredible piece of organization. But I do think that GW students could, you know, take some of that energy that they extend to things like the Women's March and bring it back to on campus, you know, every day.